innocent before proven guilty, you know? And if I get a chance to get a fair trial, and I would, you know, hopefully be exonerated in this.
So that was James Beeks back in January, before his trial on charges connected to the attack on the U.S. Capitol. And just last week, a federal judge found that Orlando man not guilty.
He is back in Central Florida, and he sat down with News 6 investigator Eric Sandoval. He joins us now here at the desk. So, Eric, what did he have to say about this ordeal?
Well, you know, you were talking about January. He really didn't have much to say when we talked to him back in January. He was getting ready for his trial up in Washington, D.C. Flash forward to now, he had a lot more to say. What went through your mind when the judge said not guilty?
I couldn't believe it myself. I mean, a lot of people are probably as shocked as I am.
And James Beeks says that he is still getting used to his trouble with the law being over. FBI agents arrested Beeks in November of 2021 while he was starring in the national tour of the Broadway musical Jesus Christ Superstar. Prosecutors claimed Beeks was a member of the far-right group, the Oath Keepers, and he was seen entering the Capitol with other members of the group in a stack military-like formation. Beeks long argued, though, that he had joined the organization just weeks before January 6th, and he went to the Capitol to help with security.
It all came down to intent, and that was, they could not prove without, the government could not approve without a shadow of a doubt, without a reasonable doubt, that I intended to go in and do that.
Beeks' case was heard by federal judge Amit Mehta, who presided over the trials of Oath Keepers national leader Stuart Rhodes and Florida leader Kelly Meigs. Both of them were convicted of seditious conspiracy.
I never knew any of those people, and it was apparent.
And Beeks acted as his own attorney.
You know what they say about somebody who represents himself in court, though?
Oh, yeah. Well, I proved them wrong, huh?
Still, you've lost like 2 years of your life because of this.
Yeah.
A lot of people would be really mad about that.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you have to salvage your reputation?
Well, it's been shattered. So, and I don't know if I'll be able to go to a Broadway audition again, you know, with this behind
really?
Me. It's kind of like a scarlet letter, just being in that orbit.
Beeks is now one of three people to be acquitted out of more than 1,000 people arrested for the Capitol siege.
Sit, lay down.
And now he's hoping to put all of this behind him.
And I get it. Just because I was there, people will not, never, probably never accept me. But, you know, I'm asking if I made a mistake, and I'm asking for forgiveness.
So we asked, and Beeks says that he is no longer a member of the Oath Keepers. He said he was horrified after January 6th and not only withdrew his membership from the group, he also denounced the group.
Wow. So what is he planning to do now moving forward?
You know, we the million-dollar question is he going to go back to Broadway? Is he going to hit the stage again? You know, he says he's actually in the process of writing a book right now about what happened, about his life and how he got out of an abusive foster home at the age of 5, found his voice, eventually starred on Broadway and traveled the world. He wants to show people he has beaten a lot, and he has beaten this.
Wow. Mm. What a story. And representing himself in
federal
court. And
representing himself, exactly.
What a story. Eric Sandoval, thank you very much.
You got it.